Hello, friends. I've just about had enough of the coverage of the Michael Jackson trial. Actually, murder. All right, just be calm. I said be calm. Just don't go down there. Anyway, it's really getting to the point that I've got to say something here. Where is the testimony of the medical examiner on the body temperature? Where is the testimony of asking the questions of about the their observation when the EMT arrived as a result of the 911 call? Where is their testimony that they could see, you know, why they wanted to just take Michael to the morgue rather than to the hospital, because of the rigour had already begun? Where is the comment? Where's the testimony of the receiving end at the hospital that the patient was looks to be going into rigour? Now that's 3 hours at least before it starts getting into the big muscles. It would start with the smallest muscles first, you know, like eyelids and things like that. But this guy, I think that Michael was lost to us somewhere between midnight and say 7 a.m. Where's the testimony of the two women that got a phone call from the good doctor about going to his locker and getting the files for Michael Jackson? That tells me that Michael Jackson was dead already, and the good doctor knew about it. And he was trying, this whole process from the time of death on, was trying to cover his own tracks. And that was trying to provide, I didn't get why in the world he would call Prince and the kids to see their father and pretend like he was just stopped breathing. You know, he's using the kids as hopefully as witnesses that they saw their father die. Now, about this doctor's qualifications, I guess you noticed that his he got his doctorate in medicine in the Caribbean. That is kind of a thriving industry for people who can't get accepted into medical school in the U.S., that they go for these ones in the Caribbean. Well, what are these medical schools? I've seen a medical school. I know what you have. You need a lot of equipment, and there's a good reason why they're always with the hospitals, because the kind of equipment that's needed is extremely expensive. So I looked up one that I recognized, and that was Aruba. Now, there is a medical school there at Aruba, and you can get I think either a veterinary degree or a doctor's degree. Now, Aruba is small, but it can give you a degree. It's only about 3 miles long, I think. And the population is only about 30,000 people. That's really small for a med school.